Shalom, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. In this great day, I'm very glad to share with you this short message focusing on our founder's prophetic dream. And I'm presenting this to you from the Archdiocese of Tabora, Tanzania. Today, I would like to reflect with you on the passage from the book of prophet Hosea, chapter 14, verses 9. The Bible says, "Who is wise? And he shall understand these things. Who is discerning? Let him understand. For the ways of the Lord are right. The righteous will walk in them, but the rebellious will stumble in them." Therefore, the book of prophet Hosea becomes an epic point of reflection on the prophetic mission and stand of Father Mermier. Imbued by the love of God and the zeal for missions, Fr. Mermier sought to strengthen the faith of the people and renew their Christian lives. Who is wise and he shall understand these things? In his desire to live among and with brothers in the community, Fr. Mermier discovered that pain and adversity are powerful vehicles to promote both personal and communal growth. Suffering occurs when life gives us something new, something unexpected, a new condition. The one who understands this will say, "Fear not the unknown, for it is where resides your great fortune." Hence, just like Hosea in the Bible, Mermier's outstanding dictum can be understood that courage is not the absence of fear, but the willingness to walk through your fear in the pursuit of a dream that is very important in life. Mermier's daring mind and dream reminds all of us that our wounds and pains must be turned into our wisdom. Our stumbling blocks, if well received, can become our stepping stones. Hence, we should never miss the opportunities that adversities and counter expectations present to us. Dear brothers and sisters, let us be true to ourselves and our destiny will come knocking. Fr. Mermier reminds all of us that let life lead us. Remove all resistance and move into a posture of surrendering to whatever that is unfolding. Mermier gets his dream after the French Revolution, which had sparked a profound transformation in the social, economic, and religious field. He was disheartened with liberal democracies, secularism, anti-Christian ideologies, and confidence in man's ability and progress in science, which were far from Christian teachings. His motto can be reframed. The seed of faith that is sown in the young minds can flourish in adulthood. This pushes him to extend his love of mission towards the entire world, spreading the good news of Jesus Christ as a symbolic and tangible gesture of reaching out to human situations and healing their brokenness of heart. Mermier reminds us that the ways of the Lord are just, and he always justifies his providence. In this, he writes to Father Sheminal from Rome, "I assure you that the beginnings are terrible and sometimes humiliating, but all the same, I must praise God and thank Jesus who has enabled me to swallow this bitterness of heart." In this, he encouraged his missionaries to accept suffering as a necessary means of our edification, purification, and commitment. The blocks become therefore a by and by to reach at a holy dream. This is the reason why he says to the remaining confrere for the guidon, "See, your friends have left. You too, you want to go? Even if all of you go, my resolution remains the same and unshaken. I want missions." Mermier was pushed by the love of God as the fundamental ground to God's people. He wished to see a righteous and transformed people. As a result of his perseverance, we can say that no one discovers his destiny, but your destiny comes and discover you. You only need to discover the ground and prepare it so that when the opportunity comes, you receive it. Hence, we should not worry of finding our destiny, but instead spend more time to understand our destiny. Nevertheless, our founder's intention was to enable the world to move humbly, with a greater vision, with a finer spirit of hope and achievement. He encourages us to embrace the wisdom of humility, to serve others, and joy and happiness will be our portion. As the wise men say, dream is the language of the soul. With this dream unshakable, he believed that the hand of God was at work in him. He only prayed to God to open up his ways, to live a life that was more courageous, more authentic, and highly loving. Hence, Mermier's experience teaches us something, that setbacks arrive to help us heal and deepen and grow more in our convictions. Hence, when he says, I want missions, he saw neither mistakes nor coincidences, because all events was a blessing from God. He warns us against the backsliding when he says, I practice patience, I learn little how to live. When I'm preaching mission, I give orders, but here in Rome, I have learned to obey. Here he indicates an outline of rise, progress, and fruits of revival. Like Mermier, let us not see failures before trying, for the greatest failure is the failure to try.